Hello students, today we are going to start with the next chapter of your textbook. The topic of the day is operators in Java. Now we have already discussed values and data types in the last module, and I hope that you all have completed the question answers of the previous chapter. So let's begin with the topic of this week, operators. An operator can be defined as a symbol which is used to perform calculations or to make comparisons. Now operands are the values or variables on which the operator works upon. For example, a plus b, where plus is the operator, but it is operating on two variables which are a and b. So these variables a and b will be called as operands. This table we have already seen in the last module, which depicts the various types of operators. In this module, we are going to discuss a bit in detail about all these operators. So let's start with the topic, the types of operators in Java. Now the operators in Java can be classified into various types on the basis of two aspects. Firstly, on the basis of how many operands are required to work upon. That means on the basis of the number of operands used with the operator. So on this basis, we have three types of operators. The first one is called unary operator. The term unary means one. So these operators work upon a single operand. For example, a unary plus, a unary minus, increment or decrement operator. The second category is binary operator. Binary means two. These operators work upon two operands. For example, arithmetic operators, relational operators, etc. The third is ternary operator. Ternary means three. This operator works on three operands. It is also called a conditional operator because it is a replacement of an if-else statement. How that we are going to discuss on a later stage. The symbol for this ternary operator is a question mark followed by a colon. Let us see an example for the same, for the ternary operator. In this example, we have a program. I started with the class declaration. An appropriate name has been taken for the class. Starting with the body of the class, we have public static void main, an empty parenthesis, and we move on to the body of main method. Inside the body of the main method, I have taken two variables x and y of integer types with the values 10 and 20 respectively. I have taken a third variable result of integer type, and I have assigned a value using a ternary operator. Now see the use of ternary operator in this statement. Result is equal to within parenthesis x greater than 10, a question mark, x colon y. Now what happens in the case of ternary operator? The condition given in the parenthesis will be checked first. That means the compiler is going to check whether x is greater than 10 or not. If this condition happens to be true, then the value x, which is written right after the question mark, will be assigned to the variable result. Otherwise, the value y, which is written after the colon, will be assigned to the variable result. That means if the condition is true, whatever is written after the question mark will be taken. And if the condition is false, whatever is written after the colon will be taken. So in this case, the value of x was 10. 10 greater than 10 is not a true statement. So what will be assigned to result? The value of y will be assigned to result. So in this case, result becomes equal to 20. So in this print statement, result 1 will be equal to 20. Next statement is result is equal to y greater than 10 question mark x colon y. Again, ternary operator is used. So this time the condition is checked. Y was 20. So 20 greater than 10 is true. So this time x is written after the question mark and it will be assigned to result. The value of x was 10. So result becomes 10. So this print statement after this statement is going to give us the result as result 2 is 10. Let us see the output now. So like I said, result 1 is 20 and result 2 is 10. I hope you have understood the concept. Moving ahead with the next thing. We are going to talk about the second aspect of the categorization of operators. So we can categorize the operators on the basis of their purpose of usage. Let's see how many types of operators we have. The first one is arithmetic operator. Now these operators are basically used for calculations. For example, plus for addition, minus for subtraction, asterisk for multiplication, a forward slash for division, it is going to return the quotient of the sum. And percent symbol is used again for division, but it is going to return remainder. Okay, Let us understand the use of arithmetic operators with the help of this program now. The class is declared with a varied name. Going into the body of the class, we have public static void main within parenthesis string args. Now the string args for the time being is optional. You don't have to write it. You can keep the parenthesis empty. We move into the body of the main method, where again I have taken two variables of integer type and the values assigned are 10 and 20 respectively. The third variable of integer type is taken, result, and the value assigned is x plus y. This is the use of arithmetic operator plus. The value is displayed using print statement. So it will be displaying the sum of x and y. So it will be 10 plus 20, that is 30. In the next statement, we are going for arithmetic operator, the second one, which is subtraction, minus symbol. So this is going to result as the difference of the two variables, and the result will be 10 minus 20, which is minus 10. In the third go, we have x into y, that means x asterisk y. So it is going to result in the product. 10 into 20 will be 200. Then the result is y upon x, that means 20 will be divided by 10 and the quotient will be returned. We know when 20 is divided by 10, the answer is 2 as the quotient. So it is going to return 2 as the answer. And finally, we have result equal to x percent 3. That means we are going to divide the variable x by 3 and the remainder will be returned. Now the value of x is 10. If I divide it by 3, it will be 3 into 3, that is 9. So 10 minus 9 is going to give me 1 as the remainder. So the answer returned and assigned to result will be 1 because it is the remainder. Remember, percent symbol is used to return the remainder of the division sum. So 1 will be assigned. Let us see the output of this program. So the first one, x plus y is equal to 30 as the sum. X minus y is equal to minus 10 as the difference. X asterisk y is equal to 200 as the product. Y slash x is going to return the quotient, so it is 2. X percent 3 is going to return the remainder, so it is 1. Hence, we can understand the use of all the five arithmetic operators. Moving ahead with the second category on the basis of the purpose of using the operator. So it is relational operators. Now relational operators are the operators which are used to make comparisons between two or more variables or literals. That is, they are used to check conditions. The result of these operators is always Boolean. That is, either true or false. As an example, we have less than, greater than, less than equal to, greater than equal to, and not equal to. So these are the six examples, six types of relational operators. Let us understand the use of these relational operators with the help of a program. We have a class with a appropriate name. The body of the class contains the public static void main with string args. Like I said, it is optional. Moving into the body of the main method, we have two variables of integer type. A is equal to 12, B is equal to 4. That is the values assigned to these two variables. In the first print statement, we are checking A greater than B is. And after the plus thing, after the message, we have put a plus sign. And then within bracket, I have written A greater than B. Remember, this is the use of relational operator and it is going to return only the Boolean type of result. So A was 12, B was 4. Is 12 greater than 4? Yes, it is. So the result of this statement will be true. In the second one, it is checking A less than B. So is 12 less than 4? No. So the result will be false. Remember, the result can either be true or false when we are talking about the relational operator. The third one is A equal to B, which is again false because 12 is not equal to 4. Next is A is greater than equal to B. So A is 12, B is 4. So 12 is greater than or equal to 4. Though it is not equal to 4, but it is greater. Therefore, the result will be true. In the next one, A is less than equal to B. 12 is neither less nor equal to 4. So this will be false. And finally, A is not equal to B. That means 12 is not equal to 4. So this will be true. So this is how the result will come. So let's see the output now. So like I said, A greater than B is true. A less than B is false. A equal to B is false. A is greater than equal to B is true because it is not equal, but at least it is greater. So anyone can be true. So A less than equal to B is false. And finally, A not equal to B is true. So that is how the relational operator works. What you need to remember is that the result of the relational operator is always Boolean. That is either true or false. Moving on to the third category, it is called assignment operator. Now this operator is used to assign the values to variables. That means we are going to give the values to the variables. Variables work like containers, and the values contained in them are the content. So the symbol for the assignment operator is equal to. There are some shorthand assignment operator also. Now what is this shorthand assignment operator? This is a way of writing the expression. Let's take one example for the same. Java provides shorthand assignment for all arithmetic operators, which saves typing time. Means instead of typing a long expression, we can make it short. That's why it is called shorthand assignment operator. So let us take the example. A is equal to A plus 2. In Java can be written as A plus equal to 2. Now if you compare both the expressions, A plus equal to 2 means the variable written on the left side will be repeated on the right side once the compiler is going to execute it. So A plus equal to 2 is actually A is equal to A plus 2. So this is a shorthand way of writing the same expression. Similarly, you can work on the minus symbol, the asterisk symbol, the forward slash symbol, and the percent symbol. So all the arithmetic operators can be used by making use of shorthand assignment operator. In the same way like we have done in this example. Okay. Moving ahead with the example of a program to understand the use of this shorthand representation. I have taken a class with an appropriate name, going into the body of the class, public static void main. Moving into the body of the main method, we have three variables of integer type. A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, and C is equal to 0. Now the next statement is C is equal to A plus B. So the value of variable C is changed. Remember, variable is the named memory location in which the values keep on changing. That's why it is called variable. So though C was initialized as 0, now the new value will be assigned to it. So as a result, A plus B means 10 plus 20. 30 will be stored in C. So the result of the print statement will be C is equal to A plus B, which is equal to 30. Now I am writing C plus is equal to A. What does that mean? It means that C is equal to C plus A. This is a shorthand assignment operator. So the current value of C is 30 and the current value of A is 10. So because of this shorthand assignment, what will happen? C will be equal to C plus A. That means 30 plus 10, which is going to become 40. So the next print statement is going to give the result as C plus equal to A is equal to 40. Let us see the result now. So like I said, C is equal to A plus B is equal to 30 and C plus equal to A is equal to 40. This is how the shorthand assignment operator works. And like it was mentioned in the previous slide, you can use any arithmetic operator while making use of shorthand assignment. This saves the typing time. Okay, moving on to the fourth category, which is logical operators. Now, logical operators are used to make multiple comparisons or to check multiple conditions at the same time. For making comparisons or checking conditions, we have relational operators, but we check one condition at a time. If we want to check multiple conditions at the same time, we can make use of logical operators. The result of these operators is always Boolean. Like relational operator, it also results in either true or false. The examples of logical operators now. We have logical AND, logical OR, logical NOT. And these are the symbols which are given on the slide as the representation of the operators. Okay. Talking about the logical AND first. A logical AND operator returns a true value only if all the conditions are true. Otherwise, it returns false. Remember, we are checking multiple conditions. So, AND operator, if it is used in between all the conditions to be checked, then the result will be true only if all the conditions are true. If any of the condition becomes false, the result will be false. Logical OR. A logical OR operator returns a false only if all the conditions are false. Otherwise, it will return a true result. That means, if we have used OR operator in multiple conditions, only if all the conditions become false, the result will be false. If any of the condition becomes true, the result of the OR operator will be true. The third category is logical not. A logical not operator just reverses the result. That is, if the result was true, it will become false and vice versa. Okay, as an example, let us see this program wherein I have taken a class with an appropriate name. Moving into the body of the class, we have the main method. Going into the body of the main method, we have three variables of integer type. Number 1 is equal to 1, number 2 is equal to 2, number 3 is equal to 9. So initial values have been given. I've taken a boolean type of variable, that is result. Remember, boolean is one of the primitive data type which can either take the value as true or false. Okay, in the next statement, I have assigned result equal to, there are condition checking now. Number 1 greater than number 2 or number 3 greater than number 1. So if you see it, number 1, though it is not greater than number 2, but number 3 is greater than number 1. Like I said, in the case of OR operator, if any of the condition becomes true, the result will be true. So this time when we are going to print it, the result should be true. In the next statement, we have the condition checking using AND operator. So number 1 greater than number 2 and number 3 greater than number 1. Though number 3 is greater than number 1, but the first condition is false. So in the case of AND operator, if any of the condition is false, the result will be false. So if I'm going to print the result this time, it should be false. Let us check the output this time. So like I said, the first result is true and the second result is false. So this is how it goes. The logical operators work in this manner. Okay, moving ahead with the next topic, that is increment or decrement operators. Now these are unary operators which are used within a program to increase or decrease the value of a given variable by 1. That means it is either going to add 1 to it or it is going to subtract 1 from it. For example, a plus plus, plus plus a, a minus minus, minus minus a, etc. Okay, now these increment decrement operators can be of two types. The first category is postfix operator. The word post means after. So in this case, first we use the value of the variable and then we make changes in it. That means we are either going to add 1 to it or subtract 1 from it. It can be either increment or decrement. For example, a plus plus, a minus minus. So in the case of postfix, you can see that plus plus and minus minus is coming after the variable. That is another thing to be noted. The next category is called prefix operator. The word pre means before. So in this case, first we are going to change the value of the variable. That means either we are going to add 1 to it or we are going to subtract 1 from it. And then we are going to use it. Now it can be either increment or decrement like it was there in the case of postfix. So as an example, we have plus plus a or minus minus a. So plus plus and minus minus are coming before the variable. Okay. So let us talk about certain numericals now. Before we start with the numericals, you need to understand whether it is postfix or prefix, the end result will always be the change of value. In the case of postfix, you are going to use the value of the variable, the current value of the variable, and then you are going to make changes in it. In the case of prefix, you are going to make the changes in the value of the variable first, and then you are going to use it. Okay, the first numerical is, okay, here we have x equal to 6 and we are going to work with the equation x is equal to plus plus x asterisk plus plus x modulus remainder 4. So let us begin with the solution of it. I am going to substitute the value of x on the right side. So we have plus plus 6 asterisk plus plus 7 modulus remainder 4. You must be wondering why x has been taken as 7. So understand it, like I said earlier, whether it is postfix or prefix, once you are through with these operators, the value of the variable always changes. Therefore, it was plus plus 6. The value of x was taken as 6. Asterisk plus plus 7 because the value of x has been updated. Now, let us simplify it further. Plus plus 6 is going to become 7 as it is prefix operation. It is an increment operator. Similarly, plus plus 7 is going to become 8. It is prefix increment again. So the end result is 7 asterisk 8 modulus remainder 4. 7 asterisk 8 means 7 into 8, which is going to give you 56. 56 when divided by 4 is going to give you remainder as 0. Why so? Because 56 is completely divisible by 4. So the final value of x is going to be 0. Moving on to the next numerical, where a is equal to 5 and b is equal to 9. We are going to work on the given equation. A plus equal a plus plus minus plus plus b plus a. This is a shorthand assignment operator. If you remember what we have seen on the previous few slides. Okay, so I'm going to rewrite it first. So it will be a is equal to a plus plus minus plus plus b plus a. And now we are going to substitute the value of a and b here. So it becomes 5 plus plus minus plus plus 9 plus 6. The final value of a has been taken as 6. Again, because we are through with the postfix operation earlier, so the value of a has been updated. Solving it further, it will be 5 plus 5. Because it is postfix, no change will be updated here. The current value of a will be used. So it is 5 plus 5 minus 10 plus 6. On solving it, we get 10 minus 10 plus 6. So that is going to give us 6 as the last answer. So a is equal to 6. The third numerical is a is equal to 10. This is the given thing for us. And we have to simplify the value of a as plus plus a plus a slash 3 minus 6. So this is going to be plus plus 10 plus 11 by 3 minus 6. How come a became 11 in the second go? I believe you have understood it. Whenever we are through with prefix or postfix, the value has to be updated. That's why in the initial go, a was 10. But in the next go, I have taken it as 11 because the prefix increment was already over. Now solving it further, plus plus 10 is going to become 11. And 11 by 3, because it is going to return the quotient. So 3 into 3 is 9. The remainder will be 2. So 3 will be taken as the quotient. So it becomes 11 plus 3 minus 6. Once we solve it further, it becomes 14 minus 6 and the value of a comes equal to 8. Moving on to the next numerical, where a is 0, b is 30, c is 40. The equation to be solved is a is equal to minus minus b plus c plus 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 b. Substituting the values here, it will be minus minus b, that is minus minus 30. It is a prefix decrement. So minus minus 30, that means we are going to change the value. It will become 29. C plus plus is postfix. So the value of C will be used first. So it will be 40. And the value of B has been changed. So it will be 29 only. So as a result, we get 29 plus 40 plus 29. Here we have to display the value of A. So it is A is equal to whatever the final result of A would be. So I believe you have understood the expression on the right side. It will be 29 plus 40 plus 29. So this is how it goes. And the final result will be 98. So the final output would be A is equal to 98. Moving on to the next question, that is X is equal to 4. We need to solve X plus is equal to X plus 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 X plus X. So first we are going to write it in the simplified form. So taking the shorthand addition as the normal addition. So x will be equal to x plus 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 x plus x. Putting the values here, it will be 4 plus 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 5 because the value of x has been updated. Plus 6 because again the value of x has been updated. So whether we are crossing the postfix or the prefix, the value will always change. Now solving it further, it will be 4 plus 4 because 4 plus plus is postfix, so the current value will be used. Plus 6 because it is prefix and again plus 6. Solving it further, it will be 20. So the final value of x becomes 20. After this explanation, let us talk about the assignment for the week. Remember, the postfix and the prefix operation is very, very important. You need to go through it carefully. And the numericals which we have discussed are to be gone through properly. Other than this, if you have already purchased the textbook, there are a number of different examples given. So kindly go through the examples also. Okay, as an assignment, you need to do the following questions neatly in your computer fair notebook. The first question is, explain the shorthand assignment operator with an example. It is clearly mentioned in the explanation, and I am going to provide the PDF file also so you can get the answer for it. The second question is, you need to write about the following operators in short: logical operator, assignment operator, and ternary operator. So you should be able to find the answer for the same. Question number 3 is, distinguish between the following: equal and equal equal. Remember, equal is assignment operator and equal equal is relational operator. Accordingly, you are going to write the differences. The second part is plus and plus plus. Plus being the arithmetic operator and plus plus is the unary operator. So one is binary, the other one is unary. You need to write the difference accordingly. Question number 4 is, we have been given the value of x and y and you have to calculate the value of the given equation. So final value of x has to be calculated. So this is a question on the basis of postfix and prefix. So these are the 4 questions that you need to attempt as the assignment for this week. So students, see to it that you complete your work and take care of yourself. Thank you.